Hello, world creators. UIDs are Godot's new way to prevent breaking scenes when we shuffle around files in our project folders. But flash news, they are not as new as you'd think. The UIDs were already shipped for the first time with the update to Godot 4.0, though the Godot devs acknowledge that this feature was not yet fully developed at that time, and there is enough reason to believe that this feature has not reached its final form yet. Since Godot 4.0, scenes and resources already used UIDs invisibly in the header information of the scenes and resource files. Imported files, like sprites or audio on the other hand, got a special .import file associated with them which could track this UID for them. Scripts and shaders, however, are pure text files and never experienced a UID implementation. So one of the two big changes with 4.4 is that scripts and shaders get an extra file associated with them, which will store their UID for them. The second big change is that UIDs will now be visible and usable in the UI. So let me show you real quick how you can use them before we move to the benefits and drawbacks. Before, when we wanted to preload a file, we had to reference it a scene by its path in our folder system to use it in our script. If we moved the file, this reference stopped working and we had a game-breaking error until we went to update the path in our script to be the correct one again. This could cause quite some headaches if you moved around a lot of files at once. Now, if you use instead of a file path the UID, you can move your scene around in your scene folder as much as you like, and your reference to your script keeps working just fine. Granted, this was already supported with the @export variables, and it only very rarely broke the path, so it was already pretty reliable. But I think it's good to know about it and play around with the UIDs a little. After all, the more tools you have in your toolbox, the easier the job becomes. Now let's wrap up with the benefits and drawbacks of these UIDs. But a short reminder, scenes and resources have this UID info stored in themselves. Imports get an .import file to track the UID, and scripts and shaders have a .uid file storing their ID. That is important to understand the benefits and the drawbacks of these UIDs. So scenes should not break anymore, even if files are moved outside of the editor. But you have to remember that you have to move the UID and the .import files with them if you move them to another location. As long as you heed to that rule, files can be moved outside of and without using the Godot editor, something that was not really possible before without corrupting scenes. As for the drawbacks of the UIDs, there are two loud voices into the room. First, there's a lot of complaints about cluttered folders with extra files like the .import and the .uid files, especially the latter ones that come new. By the way, you have to make sure that you do not put these UID files in the git ignore if you're using Git. Which also already leads to the next topic. Apparently, there's a lot of concern about merge conflicts when using the Git services. These seem to be especially a concern of people with large projects and large teams. Something I am unfortunately unfamiliar with, so I will abstain from a personal analysis about this topic. Maybe you know more. What do you think? Is this change a good one or a bad one? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, keep creating awesome games, and see you in the next one.